Okay, I'm working on the sword here. Got some 400 crit. And I'm using my mask because this is resin. And resin is very, very bad for you if you inhale it. So, it's best to be safe. Okay, so this is looking pretty smooth. And of course, this is after I've already clipped off the injection marks and such. So, it's looking pretty nice here. Yeah, it's good to sand it smooth after you've removed the injector pins and such. Actually, I could see here, I need to kind of rework this a little bit. But I just want to make this smooth. So I want to do this with metallic paint, and the smoother the better. And I'll work my way up to 600. And I think 600 should be okay. And then I'll put on I might go up to 1,000. And then apply the primer. Okay, so there's a problem with the sword here, is that it's a little bit bent. Just like you see that there's a bend to it. So what I want to do is put this down on a plate here and pour a bunch of hot water on here. Now, I don't want to use like something I'm going to be actually eating off of because resin is toxic. So I'm just going to let this soak in hot water for a while. And then I'm going to insert it into this thing of ice water here. Okay, so it's been about a minute or so. And I think it's looking a lot straighter now. Okay. So that looks pretty straight to me. What do you think? That looks pretty nice. So what I'm going to do now is stick it in here. There. I just want to get it up to the hilt because that's where the bend was the worst. I think it was the hilt itself is what kind of made the whole thing kind of bent. Because the rest of it wasn't like it was warped, you know, like at a curve. It was just kind of like that a little bit. So now it should be a bit, yep, it doesn't bend very much at all anymore. This is it. This is what I wanted. That's nice. Now let's put it down here. Kind of points, yep. There you go. So now that the sword is straightened out, what I want to do is prime it. So I'm going to use some Mr. Resin Primer Surfacer. This is made specifically for resin, obviously. That's why it's called such. Now, these are resin parts here, too, for her pigtails. But I just used the regular primer without even thinking. So I hope that there's not going to be any problem with this. I don't know. They seem to prime just fine. But what I did was I used some of this and some Mr. Leveling Color. I'm sorry, Mr. Color Leveling Thinner. And I'm going to be priming
the sword.
Okay, I'm gonna paint the sword now. To do the high shine silver metallic paint, I need to put down a coating of high gloss black. So I'm going to use, this is Mr. Hobby GX2, Mr. Color GX. This is Ueno Black. So this is a really strong black color, very high glossy.
So, we'll give it a shot. I've never used this paint before.
Alright, so next on the sword is I want to do some wet sanding with 1200 grit sandpaper. Hopefully this should make it really nice and smooth. Then I'll go over it again with another coating of Ueno Black. And then hopefully this will get rid of the texture to the surface. Now for this, you know, I don't care about this. I just want the blade part to be smooth. Alright, so let's paint the sword. You know, in the past I have used Alkalad Chrome, but today I'm going to try the Mr. Hobby equivalent. This is Super Metallic Chrome Silver, SM06. I've loaded it up into my airbrush, and I'm ready to go. So here we go. Now this stuff does not need to be thinned at all. You just pour it straight out of a bottle into your airbrush. Yeah. All right. Yeah, I will have to let this dry and then reposition the alligator clip and paint the part that's underneath here. That looks pretty nice. Okay, I'm going to use gold paint. This is Mr. Hobby Aqueous Gold. Okay, so we've got these gold Wonder Woman armband type things, and the gold paint's looking pretty nice. I like it. So I just got one more to do. As for this one, she has her magic demon ring or whatever it is. So I had to mask that off, and I used some masking solution as well to make it all masked off so I wouldn't get gold on her hands. So it's looking pretty nice. I was thinking about hand painting that, but I think it turned out nice. Hopefully, once I remove the masking, I'll see how it is. All right, so I'm gonna protect the gold with Pledge Future, and I've added a little bit of alcohol to it. This bottle's getting kind of old, so I need to thin it out a little bit every time I shoot it. Thank you. Okay, so I have not touched this model since last December, and it is now at the end of July. So I have not touched this in a long time. I put it back in the box, and unfortunately, some problems arose. Some problems arose as a result. Some paint got kind of scratched up a little bit. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to maybe repaint some of these parts. I have to go over a lot of this stuff again. There was some chafing that happened. See, there's some lines now here on her leg. I'm going to paint over that and see if I might get them to go away. The other problem is, I don't know why. Now, this is... I had used character red, Mr. Hobby 1, Mr. Color 108, and this is lacquer, and I used the flat base, and I did the dress. This worked out just fine, but when I took these pieces out of the box they were in, the red, you know, this was with the flat base, this was not, so this was like a semi-gloss. And these are tacky. Like, see, there's my fingernail, or my fingerprint right there. Not happy about that. Totally screwed this up. So what I've done here is I wet sanded it, and I might continue to do so, just to kind of strip the paint away. And I'm going to try reshooting this with. With the flat red instead to match the dress. I don't know why this happened. Maybe there's some thing with this semi-gloss paint that doesn't want to dry completely with PVC. However, there is the white primer and the flesh tone that was painted on this before the red went on. So there are two different layers of paint between this red and the soft vinyl. Did I say PVC? I meant soft vinyl. So I don't know why that happened. It's just really, really maddening. Not happy about that at all. So as you can see here, I've kind of rubbed off the paint here. But that's okay. I don't care. I'm just going to redo this anyways. This dust is gonna stick to this, you know, more than just my fingerprints. So I need to do something about that. Can't let that happen. So yeah, weird, huh? I need to get busy. All right, so I have successfully kind of repainted this mostly. I re-pre-shaded, repainted their dress. So this dress is looking a lot nicer. What I would like to do is start to tackling the details, and I have never gotten around to that yet until now. So what I have are two bottles of paints. This is accretion. These are both flat accretions. Accretion number whatever it is, I don't know, I can't remember. It's got a bunch of paint on there now. Flat black and flat white. Now these accretions are fairly nice to hand brush, so I'm just going to hand brush them, see how this goes. And see how this goes, right? So the yin and yang emblem on her chest is simply just black and white. So what I'm gonna do is I need a paintbrush, of course. You can't paint without a paintbrush, derp. And I'm just gonna fill in the inner detail first. And I think it's probably easier to do the inside and then work my way out. So this circle here becomes white. And obviously it's going to take a couple of coats. But yeah. This outside here is also white. So I just need to take the white paint around here and get this in a couple of coats. think the only real sure way of successfully doing this is hand painting this. And it's going to take a while. So I think I'm just going to cut this short here and come back to you later on. Alright, so as you can see, I have gotten really busy painting this emblem on her chest. And while it's not totally 100% beautiful, it's not bad. I think it's turning out okay, I guess. Let me just keep working at it, just do a little bit of detail. And if I screw up, I'll just kind of wait for the paint to dry, and then I'll paint it over with the other color, I suppose. That's what I'm having to do here. Kind of lost the detail. I'm not really sure where this circle is supposed to be. I kind of messed that up a little bit. I see where I need to do the black here. So I'm just using a really fine-tipped paintbrush. And getting that detail there. Let me paint that there. Okay. Nice. So again, I'm using accretion paints, and these are, you know, they kind of make it a little bit easier to hand brush stuff. If you're better at this than I am, there you can manage to do this without any paint strokes. The catch is you must use the accretion solvent. And so when I first started this, I didn't use the solvent, but now I am doing that. So yeah, it's pretty cool paint. If you can get a hold of it, I would recommend maybe checking it out, giving it a try. I mean, you can airbrush this too, of course, but I think the main point of this paint is to hand brush. So I'm trying to get her don't want to get her boobs dirty, you know, get any paint on my fingers or whatever. There we go. That looks better. I'll just keep working at it. So also something I need to do is paint the whites of her eyes. Oh my gosh, I have not yet done that. Let me go ahead and I can get started that now, I suppose. So I'll have to put down the foundation of the white for her eyes first, and probably have to slowly build it up first. And then eventually kind of draw out the way I want her eyes to be, kind of like how I did it when I first started this with pencil, and then go from there. So, hey, it's dinner time. These are pastel chalks. This is made by Nouvelle Carré Pastels. I'm going to shave off some powder. Okay. And next, what I want to do is add a little bit more shading that I kind of lost. Gonna add some shading into the cracks here. There. Just going to add a little bit of more shadow, blow off the excess. There. That's nice. So yeah, just brushing on here before doing a clear clear coat to seal it in. Yeah, that looks nice. Okay. Now, I'm not gonna redo her bust or anything like that. I don't think that would be necessary. But I'm just gonna add a little bit more shading here. Now maybe I can add some shading on her her butt crack here. Maybe. That looks nice. Alright, so I'm gonna do the same thing with the hair. I'm gonna get all the cracks in the hairdo. There we go. So yeah, you see what I'm doing. So I'm going to just continue. I don't wanna, you know, spend too much time showing all of this, I guess, but Leona's Workshop is a really good channel to look at. She does not vinyl like this. This is soft vinyl. She told me that she doesn't have the patience for soft vinyl. She only works in resin. But she does some really fantastic builds on her channel. If you're interested in learning how to do figures and such. She does fantastic anime figures, and she's a nice girl from Mexico. And check out her channel. You can follow her on Tumblr. I follow her there as well. I'm sure she has Facebook, but I don't do Facebook. So, yeah, check her out. She's super neat. She's extremely talented, and her videos are very helpful. And I have done this chalk weathering with other stuff, you know, like plastic models and such, but it was really cool to see that she does this same technique with figures, and she showed how she did it with hair and such. So, yeah, this is really cool. This is turning out pretty nice. So, yeah, Leona's Workshop, watch. And I'll get back to you on this. So you can see what's happening here, hopefully, in the light. It is filling in the cracks fairly well. And adding a bit more depth to the color of her hair. I'm probably going to do, like, the crack here, her part here, as well. So I accidentally bought Gloss Brown X9. What I wanted to do was buy some more XF10 flat brown, but... oh well, so I added some flat base to it, added some flat white XF2, and also some paint retarder. So what I'm doing now is I got this lighter brown mixture here, and I am just painting some highlights onto her hair. Because that is kind of like the way the, you know, the anime look, I suppose. Really show what I'm talking about. So this is the type of effect I'm looking for. Just do some highlights on her bangs and such. Hopefully it's going to turn out nice. I don't know. Maybe it will, maybe it won't. I hope so. Oh crap, what's this? Oh, it's okay. And so, let me look at the box here. I should probably paint some along the top up here too. just kind of do it in different... different lengths, I suppose. Maybe different intensities as well, perhaps. So I'll get back to you, show you what this is going to look like, I suppose. Not too confident this is going to turn out nicely, but we'll see. The etymology of the word varnish in Japanese, I think originally it adopted the German, which would be wanish, I guess, with a wa instead of a va, because the W's are backwards. V's and W's are opposite of each other in German. And in Japanese, I think originally it was wanisu, and it's just become nisu somehow. Don't ask me why. It just kind of got shortened. So let's use some varnish on here. I think it might already kind of be varnished, though, by the looks of this. Let's just go ahead and varnish this up. It looks pretty nice. Now I can get rid of this old grody towel. I was using a varnish for something else, actually. We were overrun with mildew during the previous rainy season. So I was using some varnish to kind of protect the backs, and the mildew really proliferated along the backside of some bookshelves. So that's why I bought this stuff. And I can get rid of this crusty old towel now. Just put this away. There. Okay, so that is varnished. I'm going to let this just air dry. And the stand looks kind of nice now. Thank you. this model, and it's taken almost 2 years to complete, and I am getting pretty excited. So, as you can see, the hair is all ready to go, and the face turned out better than I thought it would. So I've had some setbacks. I had an SD card that lost its formatting in the middle of transferring a whole bunch of files to my computer, and I had to pay for some program to retrieve files. And you have to format them. You have to format the SD card, and then use this program to try to retrieve your files. And I got most of them, so still some stuff got messed up. And on top of that, I had that fiasco with my models directory getting accidentally deleted when I just tried to delete one file. So I had to try to retrieve those files as well. Anyhow, so in the interest of time, I just did just that montage at like 4x speed, just to get through there real quick. What I would like to do is maybe re-airbrush the gold here, because I see that some of it's gotten kind of scuffed up. The dress here, I think, has turned out nice. I had to do a little bit of touch-up. What I want to do is do like a semi-gloss kind of a sheen to this. These dresses, these Chinese dresses, they're called cheongsam. Usually the thread is really kind of reflective, so I want to try to capture that essence a little bit with doing a gloss clear coat on here. So that's what I might do that next. So in the interest of time, I'm not going to video that. I'm just going to go ahead and just get started on this, and then we'll do the final assembly.
Okay, so I'm going to use the CA glue. To do her hair here. Okay, let's do the other side. Oops, sorry, this is not in frame. And here we go. Isn't that cute?
Okay, I'm having trouble with the face here. I'm getting it kind of scraping off some of the brown paint from her hair. I'm not happy about that. I'm gonna try to get this hair. I'm not happy about this, the way this is fitting together. It's not as easy as I thought it was going to be. Not happy. This might actually fit so that I don't even need to glue it, maybe. Maybe. Now, I redid the blue on her hair braids. I used this Delta Saran coat. This is Blue Bayou.
Hey, Papa, Mama said it's okay to the game.
Alright, go get it.
Maybe it has
it. I don't know. You go find it. Find it. Hmm. There. All right, it's fit. Oh, good. All right. The scrapes have been kind of covered up anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So, here you go. Very cool. Very, very happy about that. Very cool. So, here we go. That is cool, isn't it? that, oh my gosh, this is my first anime figure, so this, I'm really excited about this, but that is so beautiful. I'm really happy I got her eyes fairly well. That is just so cool looking. Alright, so, her head is in a place, it's not going to move at all, no glue is necessary whatsoever. Now, what I've done is squeezed some Future into this little thingy here, this dish, and what I want to do is... where's my paintbrush I like to use? Here we go. I'm just going to do her eyes with Future. So I'm going to give her eyes kind of a glossy look. And, because everybody's eyes are kind of glossy looking, right? This is so freaking cool, dude. I'm so happy about this. Let me tell you about it. I'm happy. Okay. 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 Yeah, very, very cool. Alright, so something else I need to tell you about. So I was not happy with how the sword turned out. Okay. The sword didn't really, worked very well for me. So what I did was, I repainted it. Sorry, I was just interrupted by my little girl. So, I just did the eyes. Oh yeah, that's right, I was telling you about the sword here. Okay, so, I have done this over again with Alclad. I just went ahead and just used Alclad Chrome, and this looks fantastic. What I did differently this time was, not only did I use that GX black, that Ueno black, I went over it again, I polished it, went over it many times with the Tamiya polishing compound, and made it super smooth. Now this sword looks freaking cool. Now, the problem is, with Alclad, is that when you rub it, it'll kind of come off on your fingers sometimes, depending on how well it sticks. I picked this up. Now, in America, you can probably get this fairly easily. For me, this is really, really difficult. First, I looked at AmiAmi, put in an order for this, couldn't find it. It was all sold out. They contacted the supplier, which is probably Platts, and or their intermediary, wholesaler or whatever, and did not find it. So they gave me a message telling me, sorry, good luck. We can't get this for you. I did find this on Amazon Japan. There was one seller that had this. There were two bottles left, and I got one. So, Alclad 2 Lacquer. This is Aqua Gloss Clear. This is a clear coat that goes onto Alclad Chrome or any of their metallic paints, and it does not fog it up. The problem with Alclad is that if you use just like Future or any sort of clear coat, it's going to fog it up, but with this, it's not going to. So it's specifically made for Alclad, so I'm going to shoot this in the airbrush. Also, the little demon's skull thing here, I want to redo this with gold paint. I'm going to use accretion gold, because this hand paints on fairly well. Okay, we got this Alclad 2 Lacquer Aqua Gloss Clear. I'm not sure if this is lacquer or not, or if it's acrylic, but it says on the website you can just dump it directly into your airbrush and go. So, got some in there. Let me put my mask on.
So I got this tacked onto a skewer here. Let's give this a shot. Hopefully this is gonna stay sticking out here. Okay. I'm just going to let this dry and put on another coat.
Okay, so it kind of did cloud up the sword a little bit, slightly, but then again, maybe I didn't clean out my airbrush thoroughly enough. I did use the Future on the dress, and I had run it out with a bunch of the airbrush cleaner here, and then sprayed, so who knows. Anyhow, it's not so bad, though. I'm more or less satisfied with this. So I'm okay with this. So what I'm doing now is painting the gold. And here you go. There's the demon head on her sword. Pretty freaking cool. Neat stuff. That's really cool. I need to wash off some of the polishing compound, but I'll have to wait till this is dry. Okay, so as you saw with the music going, with the montage and all that, I was doing some pinning. Okay, so this is just a brass pipe that I have put into here. Now, this hole here is just from the with that toothpick, you know, where I had it on the skewer here. Okay, so what I did was I put some regular putty, Tamiya putty in there, and secured this pin. So it's all dry now. What I can do is fill in the epoxy putty into this hole here, and then use the CA glue to secure it into place. Let's go ahead and do that now. You can see here I've done her lower parts. This up here. Okay, so I already have a bunch of this epoxy putty. Just need to get my fingers wet. Okay, so that little peg is gonna fit into this hole here. And what I need is this putty to, you know, for it to skewer into this putty here, and then when it dries, it'll be nice and solid. Okay. There. Okay, so this is nice and solid here. Now. Okay. So as you can see, the dress here is really nice and shiny. I like it. Oof, don't want to... There. Don't want to drip the CA glue on the model here. Alright, so I've got lots of CA glue. I have to say again, this is using super glue so much easier with this stuff. Having that nice brush. Alright, so this fits in here, and I'm just going to have to hold this. But you see here, her armpit is right there. There, okay. So there you go. I'm just going to hold this though. I don't want to just leave it. I want to make sure that the glue dries, super glue dries here. See. There. Okay. There. See that? That's nice. Okay, so I'm going to try to put her beautiful head into the socket here. So I got some of this putty here. I don't really need to use a whole lot though, because this is, it's a socket. And because of that, don't think, you know, there's much room to use this stuff. I'm just going to just cram this in the hole here. Okay. Now, I'm going to put the CA glue. Be careful not to drip it on the model. Okay. I'll make sure this gets adequately glued. There. Okay, so this is so exciting. I've already done a dry fit, so I know this is gonna work. It worked before. There. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Isn't that so cool? Oh my gosh, that is so cool. Oh man, this is exciting. This is so cool. There she is. You know, with her head in place, I guess her boobs don't look that big. It's more in proportion, I guess, after all. So that's really cool. Now the sword is going to have to fit inside her hand, and hopefully it'll just stay there. Now, I'm not going to connect the bottom and the top together yet, because I just want to make sure that this stuff dries. Give this putty a couple hours or so to set. But this is so cool. That is so cool. So about an hour has passed, and this is pretty much solidified. Still, I'm going to just leave this alone for now. I don't want to take any chances with I got her butt here. It's really beautiful. And I just want to make sure that everything's going to be, you know, totally, totally set and ready to go. And I don't want to really touch this very much, okay? But here you have her two halves, her lower half and her top half. And I'm going to finish this video right now, and I'm going to call this stage complete, and the next video you will see the final assembly and showcase. So thanks for watching so far. This is pretty exciting. Take care. Goodbye.